Hi, my name is Shahad Umar from 10G1, and today I'm going to be showing you how to solve exponential equations. These are some properties that make solving the equations easier. For our first example, we have 8 to the power of 4x plus 2 equals 64. Now let's go through the ways I can write these. I can express 8 by saying 2 to the power of 3, so it will turn into 2 to the power of 3 raised to the power of 4x plus 2. Our goal for it is to have the same base, so 64 has to be 2 raised to something, and that just so happens to be 2 raised to the 6th power. Now solve 2 to the 3rd raised to the 4th plus 2. The first property stated that we should multiply the exponents. So 3 multiplied by 4x is 12x, plus 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. Now I have the same base, so I should set the exponents equal to each other. And when I solve for x, I will get 12x equals 0, so then x equals 0. Our second example is going to be 1/5 raised to the x minus 5, that's equal to 25 raised to the 3x plus 2. I know that 25 is the same as 5 squared, so if I substitute that in, I get 3x plus 2 on the right side. On the left side, I don't need this fraction, so according to the fourth property, 1/5 is the same thing as 5 to the negative 1. So I have 5 negative 1 raised to the x minus 5. Now let's use another property, multiplying a power raised to a power. So this becomes 5 to the negative x plus 5 equals 5 to the 6x plus 4. Since the bases are the same, we are going to set the exponents as equal and ignore the base. Negative x plus 5 equals 6x plus 4. We can add the x over and subtract 4 from both sides. The x cancels each other and so does the 4, and we are left with 1 equals 7x. Divide 7 by both sides. That leaves us with x equals 1 over 7. For our third example, let's look at the following equation. 5 to the 3x equals 1 over 25. Since we already have the base of 5, we can also try to change the 125 so it can have a base of 5. After figuring out that 5 to the power of 3 equals 125, we can start substituting. So 5 to the 3x stays the same, and 1 over 125 changes to 1 over 5 to the power of 3. Now, using the laws of exponents, we want to move the 5 to the power of 3 from the denominator to the numerator. After moving the 5 up, the exponent turns into a negative because that's the law of exponents. So now we have the bases equal, we move on to solving the exponents. 3x equals negative 3. Divide both sides by 3 and you will be left with x equals negative 1. Moving on to our fourth example, 2 raised to the 7th x times 8 equals 256 raised to the x. We already have a base of 2, so it will be easier for us to change the other two numbers. So 2 raised to the 7th multiplied by 2 to the 3rd equals 2 to the 8th raised to the x. Using a law, we can rewrite this as 2 raised to the 7th x plus 3 equals 2 to the 8x. Quick note, we can multiply the 8 and x so we get rid of the parentheses. Again, we have like bases, so we can put the exponents equal to each other in a little equation. Now, 7x plus 3 equals 8x. Subtract 7 from both sides, and you're left with 3 equals x. Now, example number 5. 4 to the 2x plus 3 equals 1. We want to write the number 1 as 4 to some power. Now we're going to set our exponents equal. Then, just subtract 3 from both sides, then divide by 2, and you'll be left with x equals negative 3 halves. And lastly, example number 6. 3 raised to 1 minus 2x equals 243. We want to change the 243 so it has a base of 3. 3 to the power of 5 equals 243. You'll be left with 3 raised to 1 minus 2x equals 3 raised to the 5th power. After that, I can go ahead and set my powers equal and solve this equation. 1 minus 2x equals 5. We can rewrite it as 1 minus 5 equals 2x. Negative 4 equals 2x. Divide by 2 and you will be left with
x equals negative 2.